he's gearing up for this weekend's big live show on History Channel. Travis Pastrana, good morning.
What's up, bud?
Good morning, guys. How y'all doing?
Waiting here with clenched cheeks for what you're going to do this weekend. Walk people through the history of the jump that you're about to make, the Evel Knievel jump, and your own spin on it this weekend on the History Channel.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, this is a tribute. We've got, Evel Knievel was the original stuntman. He's the guy that I was brought up on with my dad. You know, you're not a failure until you fail to get back up. And don't be a sissy, back when men were men.
But
I'm actually sitting here, I'm looking at my room at the Caesars Palace, and they've got the jump is just being built, literally right now, out front. So we basically get to jump the most infamous and iconic jump probably ever done in stunt lore. I think mostly because of all the people that have crashed on it. Evel Knievel included, and David Wells, trying to jump over the Caesars Fountain. Since then, there's been some guys that have done it on regular dirt bikes. I mean, I would jump at 14 years old. I went over 200 feet. But the bikes that we're jumping now are a lot, they're half the weight, three times the suspension travel. They're built to fly. Where I'm jumping for this tribute, basically a street bike, a V-twin 750cc tank.
It's an Indian Scout FTR 750 V-twin that is described as being a great motorcycle, but a terrible choice for jumping. Like you pointed out, like in your new film, incredible Action Figures 2, Crackle exclusive, you do two back-to-back double backflips on a dirt bike, but this dirt bike weighs a quarter of what this thing does. So while you can pull off some of those incredible maneuvers that you and everybody in the Nitro Circus does, this thing is not meant for it. How fast do you have to get going? What's the ideal speed to be able to make it?
Oh, that's a great question. hopefully, it should be pretty spot on. But that's the thing. I mean, heck, we've flown buses, we've flown with all the Red Bull gear and the limits. Jumped cars, jumped snowmobiles, and all this stuff. This is a tribute. Yeah, History Channel came to Nitro Circus and said, what can we do? We want a live event. We want something that has a lot of, a lot of history. To put it bluntly, no pun intended there. But, we were sitting on the table and we're like, Evel Knievel. I'm like, I want to jump Caesars Fountain. I'm like, is there any way to make this happen? And we started thinking of all Evel's most iconic jumps. And, the Greyhound bus jump came out. I'm like, dude, that'd be amazing. Let's do the Greyhound bus. What about the car jump? You jumped 50 cars. So we're jumping, or I'm jumping a couple more buses than he jumps, a couple more cars, but really it's just a modern-day spin on it. We still have to push ourselves. We still have to go as far as we can. And, the biggest jump, probably the bus jump, right around 180 to 200 feet. This motorcycle will be four stories in the air. So it's like jumping 500 pounds attached to your feet, four stories in the air, and at approximately 85 miles an hour. So
damn,
I think Evel said it best.
They
said, what's it feel like to crash on this thing? He said, well, go stand on a step ladder, basically a ladder, four story tall, and go down the freeway at 85 miles an hour and jump off. Hopefully it'll be a little better than his description, but it's going to be a hard landing for sure.
Yeah, it's going to be 8 o'clock History Channel this Sunday. Keith Mills.
Hey, Travis, Keith Mills. Hey, thanks for sending us the video of the trailer of the movie. It's unbelievable, incredible action. But at the end of it, there's a tagline that says, has Travis lost his mind? I got a kick out of that. Was that you putting that on there? And have you?
No. I don't think someone says you got a death wish. I'm like, man, if I have a death wish, I'm failing pretty miserable right now. At the end of the day, to wake up with the passion, to wake up, with being able to spend this time with my family, to travel the world, it's been a lot of fun. I'm definitely 34 years old. I'm not saying this is my last hurrah, but that Action Figures movie has a bail on crackle. Like, we put our heart and souls and there was some injuries along the way, but everyone really pushed what we thought was possible. The human spirit, the whole, how far can we go? How high can we go? How fast can we go? We had a lot of fun, and to travel the world with that many passionate people, and doing stuff that everyone says is impossible. And at the end of the day, hey, we're traveling the world on kids' toys, scooters, BMX bikes, motorcycles. But I always wanted to never grow up. And You've accomplished that. Still making it happen.
Yeah, you've absolutely succeeded. Travis
Pastrana. Hey, you need to get to 35, though, brother. We got to see you at 35.
Yeah, it's going to be Sunday, trying to jump over the Caesars Palace Fountain. 16 Greyhound buses, 50-plus cars, all doing it Evel Knievel style. Travis, I'll be watching, and I hope we can talk to you maybe in the weeks to come when you are, fingers crossed, safe and sound after this, Travis. Thank you for joining us, man.
Always a pleasure. Thank you, guys.
Thanks, Travis. Travis Pastrana.
I tell you what, you talk about a zest. His next book should be How to Live Life, man. Not jumping over buses and stuff, but just go for it.
The guy squeezes every last drop of life out of his existence.
I think I told you this story. When I was at Channel 2, he was 7 years old, and his father called and said, hey, you got to come down and check out my son. And the reason was he's because he was already making a name for himself in dirt bikes, and his uncle Alan was an NFL football player with the Denver Broncos, went to University of Maryland, and he taught at Anne Arundel Community College. And, man, this kid back then, he had a little makeshift, nothing like he has now. You've been there. He had a little makeshift course in the back of his house in Annapolis. And, man, he was flying around like I've never seen anything like it. You're thinking, man.
And this kid's got no fear. Now he's
20 years later, man. 30 years later, I should say.
And we apologize for the poor phone quality.
But he's in Vegas.
I don't know. They don't have good phones in Vegas.
Who knows where?
You know, it might be in a casino or something.
Yeah, landlines around here, sand lines around trying to get some communication. Hopefully the technology on the ramps is better than is in that hotel room
Can you imagine, at the point of go, when you're getting ready to jump over the fountain at Caesars, where you knew has had this history of Evel Knievel, and he mentioned some other guys, and
his son did it also. It put Evel in a coma for 3 weeks.
I mean, this is not just jumping over a couple of cars and, you know, in the backyard or a couple of flips like you guys did that day when you went down his house, man. This is life or death.
This is huge, and like you heard him say at the beginning, or maybe you couldn't. It was a little hard to hear him. He's not doing this on a jumping bike. He's doing this on a massive hog, like V-twin Indian motorcycle. This would be like trying to do a backflip on a Harley. He's doing something on a device not meant for that thing. Mm. When you see him doing these tricks and these jumps and doing all these crazy things, I think he leapt like the Great Wall of China.
Yeah, right.
He's on a bike that you might actually be able to lift up with two hands. You need a crane to lift this thing up. So the suspension, think about the landing. The shocks on this thing, when you land, it's going to be just like having a 2,000-pound brick in your ass.
And you can't practice it. We mentioned that yesterday, 2 days ago.
Oh, you do it or don't.
You can't. I mean, it's not like you can do some practice runs to get a gauge for your speed.
Yeah. It's like when people do all that wingsuit stuff down the side of a mountain where they're like 8 feet off the ground. How do you practice that? You either do it perfect or there's just a crimson smear down the side of some...
And I'm watching the old ones, and it's it's after you land, you have to, like, thread the needle through this little, like, service entrance tunnel that goes underneath.
Right. That's the last part.
And that's what Evel Knievel, like, look at this.
Wow.
Look where he threads right through.
Oh, man. It's like going through a loading dock, right? He's right. This is like a service tunnel where they make deliveries.
And Evel kind of flopped off the back of the motorcycle and slammed into the wall.
Scott, have you seen the video now that he sent out, 2-minute little
trailer? Yeah, we just watched
it. Oh, my God, it's unbelievable.
So is this to simulate Evel Knievel's jump
with the bike?
Yeah, he's going to try and succeed where Evel couldn't. And I don't think his son did either. He's going to try and make this landing successful. Now, this is a guy, Travis Pastrana, in this new film, the video that these two gentlemen are referencing.
Action Figures 2.
He jumps a dirt bike over an attack helicopter, over top of the blades. In the attack helicopter, they have a Vulcan chain gun at full speed, someone just holding down the trigger. There's a guy hanging onto the attack helicopter with a handgun, shooting at cars, making them explode one at a time. Underneath of the helicopter, a rally car is doing drift racing, all in this one scene of perfectly orchestrated chaos.
And he's going over top of the helicopter.
To where if one domino doesn't fall perfect in this. Mm-hmm. Everyone dies. Everyone's on fire. Everyone's getting chopped
Any
up.
Any idea who directed the movie? Have you ever met him?
I don't know. No. Ooh, he's very hands-on with
it. Question is why?
Because we're white people. And for some reason, we love to swim with sharks.
You guys love the thrill.
Well, he's been doing that since he's been in the crib, man.
He loves it.
That's his life.
He doesn't have a death wish. He has a taste for life.